Yo, what is up, YouTube? So I wanted to do something different on my channel, just for content sake and to keep my channel active. And shout outs to the new subscribers that I've noticed them. I haven't kept up with the numbers for a while, but I see that we have more subscribers now, so I want to thank you guys for that. Anyway, so what I'm doing right now is I'm playing Forza Horizon 5, and so it has accessibility features. Pretty much for blind players specifically, has a screen reader that reads, I'd say, 90% of everything that's on screen. So the menus and messages that pop up and everything. But the only thing where it doesn't read it is it's this map thing that you choose to pick a route where you can go. But there is this GPS system too that you can use. So for example, well, first of all, let me turn
D-pad
this
up,
off.
I need
Okay,
accolades.
Carlos. I
D-pad
have
left, what's
disabled
new this
head-to-head for
season?
you.
D-pad right, I want to race. D-pad down, disable head-to-head.
So yeah, it's reading that, and that's cool, right? But I want to go to like an event. So for example,
D-pad up, I need
D-pad then.
accolades.
Okay,
D-pad
Carlos.
left, what's
There's
new
a
this
showcase
season?
nearby.
D-pad right, I
Plotting
want
your
to
route
race.
now.
Okay, so she says there's a showcase.
D-pad down, Anna. D-pad left, Link.
And for driving, so pretty much I set it up where the AI pretty much drives for me, and I just push this button because honestly, this is just more like a relaxing game. Like I like you can just drive around. The sound design in this game is really good. Like this default vehicle that I'm using right now is like I like it, and the fact that I get to do that, so it's nice. Obviously, like at a more like hardcore level, like if you want to be like a badass driver, kind of like how like we do it in fighting games where some of us take the time to learn the frame data and like not just worry about combos and that's it, but no, we actually look
In
at like
400
very detailed
yards,
stuff.
turn left.
But here, I'm a filthy casual. Although there's a trick to it too, like I'm driving right now, and whenever she says turn left, I kind of like stop holding the trigger to slow down a little bit so that the car can just turn accordingly. So it's nice to have that. Well, let's see if we can find an event though, because that's one thing that is. I don't know if they'll fix this or not, but I know that they have an accessibility department, and they said they're open to feedback. So
Turn left.
they did something really cool for the hard of hearing though. Like I think there's a ASL interpreters in the game now too. So that is like really, really cool. But for blind players, I always feel like it's more difficult, and there's still some hesitancy on reaching out and getting more feedback.
In 200 yards, you will arrive at your destination.
Okay, so I'm gonna slow down. Alright, there should be a pop-up that tells me if I'm in the event.
On a wing and a prayer.
See, it's
On a
always on
wing
a
and
wing
a
and a
prayer.
prayer.
Option highlighted. Solo. Option one.
Alright, so let's do it. Screw it.
Loading.
So, just so we can have fun. I've done this so many times. But let's do it again for the sake of this video. But after this, I won't be able to do any other event. That's the problem. It keeps sending me
Loading.
back to the same one. But screw it. Let's have fun just for the sake of this video. Let's get it. Here we go. Dude, the sound is really good though.
Option highlighted. Start race.
And away we
This is Scotty
go.
Tyler broadcasting to you live from a plane. This time we are going everything we have got in this supercar. Let's get it. Pilot, there's a temple on the runway. Temple on the runway!
And away we go. So yeah, the AI is doing everything like the driving and stuff. I'm just holding the trigger, but it's still fun. Hey, see? That plane passing by, I can hear it. Like the sound design is so good. I get to do this. So yeah, I'm a filthy casual on this game. Like, I'm literally just holding the trigger and just sitting back and enjoying the sound design. But I mean, I'm still like, you know, like actually feeling part of the game, you know?
Fans at the stadium going wild. Yes. What's it gonna take to beat
them? I love the haptic feedback though that the game has whenever you're driving too. Like, it's really nice. But if you guys could tell, like, the pop-up messages read, like, whenever the game pops up.
Hey, the cargo doors are opening. You want me to shut this up? Oh, that was the plan?
Let's go.
Go Team Motorcycle. Now it's a race horizon. Superstar driver versus Daredevil biker. Who you got?
But this is like the only event, like I said, that Anna, the GPS system, keeps tracking whenever, and if I try to search for other ones, like, I have a hard time trying to find the events, and then I just get stuck, like, trying to find these events whenever, like, I set up a new one. And it always defaults to this one for some reason. Dude, see, like, I can hear the car, like, on my left side just pass me by, or if I pass it by, but, like, the sound design is cool. I'm also using a combination of HyperX Cloud headphones along with an Astro Mix Amp Pro, and like I made it where it sounds like really good.
Hey, did we lose a biker?
Yo, let's go! I love it! Come on!
Pilot, what is that?
So I hope that they update features for blind players. Like, it would be cool. Either the screen reader reads the map to read your destinations where you want to go to, like different events, or have Anna, you know, actually track different events instead of the same one every time you start the game up. And we did it! Boom! Let's go!
On a wing and a prayer. A button continue, X button restart. What?
No, we're not doing that. There we go. Alright, well, listen. Appreciate you guys watching this little short video on this game.
A button skip.
I feel like this game could have so much potential.
Loading.
But
loading.
The screen reader is great. I think it's awesome that they have a screen reader feature, and you know, you're able to customize like how you play the game. But it just, that's the one
loading.
Thing. Is that? It's just getting that the GPS to like give us new ones.
Stick button while parked to toggle the roof.
So that will be the only cool thing. I know they did like a major update, and they actually have ASL interpreters in game now. That's really like really cool for them to do that. Well, blind players? Nah. But anyway, with that, I am out, y'all. Just wanted to do this quick video for Forza Horizon 5. I love it, but you know, it just ends right there. So, but we still can play with friends and everything, so that's cool, like multiplayer. So, alright, I'm out. Just wanted to do a quick video for you guys. I'll catch you guys later. We'll see you around. Peace out. And I'll catch you guys later. Be sure to hit the like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and don't forget to hit the notification bell for new upcoming videos. So, with that said, this is your boy Rattlehead signing out. Peace.